Some better work, 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 work. When you walk a line, 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 line. I'm in the cafe, my tartin. Dry me, I desert you. No time to have you lurking. You make a like, now you don't like it. You know I dealt with you the nicest. Nobody touched me in the righteous. Nobody text me in a crisis. I believed all of your dreams are duration.
Hello, good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome back to Spotlight's Creative Cooking by Spotlight. Of course, with me, our special guest this afternoon, we have the man Errol, aka Country, which you've seen in the previous episode, as well as we have the man Lamar. And they are my executive chefs for this afternoon's meal that we're going to prepare. It's going to be something fabulous. We're making brown stewed pork with rice and peas, little fried chicken on the side, and carrot juice. Now this is a big meal to look about. But of course, you know, Country working the hotel industry for over 10 years, and of course he's gonna teach me, he's gonna take us through the steps. Now Errol, Country, tell him a little bit about yourself.
Well, about myself, well, I am a fun person. I love singing, you know. I'm a person that very jovial always, you know.
Yes. Indeed.
You know, I always make people happy, you know. I like to see when people is happy, you know. I'm an entertainer also, you know, in everything.
Most,
you know.
Definitely.
Yeah. I'm, you know, a family man. Yeah.
And this is Lamar, and I've known Lamar for years.
Over the past 8 to 9 years.
Yes. And Lamar, will you do a little bit of cooking?
Yes, I do. Indeed, I do a little cooking for my family. I also used to attend the College of Heart Academy to do my food and beverage course. And in the future, I'm going to finish it. As you can see, I'm a nice, kind, and jovial young man. Intelligent, loving, and caring. Wow.
Yes. So ladies and gentlemen, there you have it. Creative Cooking by Spotlight with our special guests. And now we're going to proceed. We're going to get ready to prepare our delicious meal. Ladies and gentlemen, thank you. Stay tuned for more entertainment and cooking.
We'll be right back.
Yes, indeed, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome back. Welcome back to Creative Cooking by Spotlight. And now, as I don't know what's going on, Lamar, can you explain?
Well, we are here now in the kitchen this afternoon. Here with my head chef, Errol. First, I'm gonna give him a piece of thyme to put in our rice and peas.
Yeah, man, very important that we have thyme in our rice and peas.
Then we're gonna crush up the scallion as usual. You know, our grandmother taught us to do this back in the days.
Mm-hmm.
And then I'm gonna hand it to him.
Yeah,
and then I'm gonna give him a green country pepper to make the rice and peas spicy as usual. Here you go,
right,
sir. And then I'm gonna give him a Maggi coconut powder and then a Caribbean Chice coconut powder to make the rice and peas mild and mellow.
Yes, because these are really nice, you know, especially these are very strong. Have strong one. These are very strong.
Yes.
The coconut milk, the Maggi coconut milk is,
yes,
more
indeed,
stronger. It's thicker. The
and better.
Coconut powder, you understand, the Caribbean Chice is also a good brand. So, and we want the rice and peas to taste nice.
Can you tell us what you started with the peas with?
Okay, so what we started the peas with, you know, as usual, we put the peas to soak.
Mm-hmm.
Like what our grandmother used to taught us from overnight.
Mm-hmm.
So we put the peas to soak a little with a little piece of garlic and stuff like that. You understand? Because we are doing a kind of a country style cooking.
Yes.
You understand? So we put a little piece of garlic and the peas to soak. Then we just cook the peas, as you know, after, you understand, in the morning we get up, so we just cook the peas, you understand,
and
there it is
well
now
rich.
And there it is now, so we just add in the coconut milk, the Caribbean Chice coconut powder,
and then I'm gonna hand him a little season up, all-purpose seasoning.
Yes, the all-purpose Maggi season. Remember, we have to cook with Maggi, because Maggi
make the pot flavorful.
Yeah, man, full of flavor. And it works, like, as I said, we're just gonna put the whole of that inside. Just put all of that inside.
Yes,
here.
Then we have a little piece of butter here. We're gonna put all of it in it to let it so nice.
Right.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is Creative Cooking also. Today's show is all about music and food, so later on we'll be giving you a little bit of karaoke. Country, can you sing a little one-two line right now? Just give me a little line of a song.
Redemption song, the song of freedom, is all I ever have. Redemption song. Yeah, man, so later on, we'll give you more. Just a little
more. Up.
So ladies and gentlemen, there you have it. Of course, we are going to upgrade. We're going to come back and we're going to let you know what's going on. But right now, you have the seasoning. You're getting ready for... That is for the to go in there as well.
Yeah, man. So we just have to put in a little,
put a little piece of ginger.
You know, Jamaican ginger. We are talking the real Jamaican ginger that full of spice. So you can't cook your rice and peas without a little ginger. Very good. So we just have to mix up a little and put a little piece of onion. And that's onion. That's all we're putting in right now. For now. So our rice and peas is getting, you know, put together.
Sorted out.
Yes. Smells good. Together. It smells good.
Yes. And it smells so good too.
So great.
So you know, after we finish. As we mama always said, what a day, you know, if you eat your rice and peas. I'm not going to talk to eating or whatever, you know, if you put in a little style, because a country style,
yes.
You understand?
Who made cooking.
Who right. So right about now, we'll be back with
enough
more. Mm-hmm. All right, so here we go right about now. This is the pork. The pork was seasoned up from yesterday overnight, you know. The best way is to season it up and make it go down into the meat, soak into the meat, even the bone. That means when you're eating it, you have that nice seasoning taste that is in there. So what we base it with a little browning. As you can see, the pork is a little brown. A little Chinese sauce, yes. And Scotch bonnet pepper. I blend the scotch bonnet pepper and the garlic and the onion, the scallion and the thyme. You blend those things. It's very good to go natural, especially when you're cooking in this area. You have to come natural these days because, you know, a lot of people having sickness and all of those things, and they start to blame. You can't take too much in the body. And some people say certain things are good for you, but it's not true. Everything is good for you is the amount that you take or put into your body. So right about now...
Is alcohol good for me?
If alcohol good for you? Mm-hmm. Alcohol is good for you.
It's a part of medication.
Right, but is the amount of the alcohol that you put in your body?
Right.
All right. So there and then. So right about now, so we just gonna add this pork to this little oil that we already put in the pot with a piece of ginger and a piece of garlic.
Oh,
so we put it in, we start to put it in.
The pork right like here. Chicken leg.
The pork looks like chicken leg. Maybe it's a chicken leg.
Brown stew pork, ladies and gentlemen.
Mm-hmm. Brown stew pork.
Jamaican
style jerk pork. Brown stew pork.
Okay.
Right? So the real Jamaican natural seasoning.
Yes, country, because smell it.
And it's, well, smells
wow,
so nice.
Smell it.
And it smells so nice, cooking. But that not only the smell alone, but the taste.
Taste is very nice.
Because the taste is going to be over magnificent.
All right, so what are you doing now?
So right about now, I'm just putting it, I'm just going to scrape everything in.
Yes.
So because it was blended season, so we don't have no season leaving anywhere. So we're just going to put everything in. Just like that. Yeah, man.
Mm-hmm.
You can smell the aroma.
Indeed.
Right,
tell me what you're doing with the rice in
here. Well, I'm here. Just pick my rice. Wash my rice.
Mm-hmm.
About to put it in to cook my rice and peas.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Here I am right now, standing beside my head chef, Errol.
Mm-hmm.
I'm going to ask my head chef, Errol, to take off my pot cover.
Mm-hmm. Right about now,
yes.
Problem.
Okay, the pot cover.
And I'm going to pour, my rice into my coconut powder and all my seasoning.
Yes.
Here I go with a scoop of the rice.
Wow.
As our mother always said, first time when we want the rice to swell, we always put one scoop in and said, like we call names.
Names, yes.
Okay.
That each person had a scoop.
Right.
So the plate never empty.
Right.
So I am here this afternoon to do some rice and peas, me and my head chef.
Mm-hmm.
He's also here stirring the pork.
Yeah, man, the pork and fire, I'm telling you.
Smelling so good.
So good.
I wish I could have this right now, even though it's not complete.
That's what Chinese people do with rice.
But I'm not sure. If it's how Chinese people do rice,
yeah.
Well,
most of them,
it all depends on what they are preparing. Yeah. You understand?
So you say you dip your hand in and call a name.
Yes, you call a name. For example, you dip your hand like as you
dip yourself. Right. This is for Lamar.
Yeah, right. Okay.
This is for Kenny.
Right.
Yes. This is for my head chef, Errol.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
This is for Sandre.
Mm-hmm.
And if anybody who come in, who never called, could get a little scoop of this.
Yes. Same way, yes.
Well, so I'm here gonna strain off the water because I'm not completely putting the rice as yet.
Right, so here's our pork in our pot. See it looking like it's ready or it's getting there. The pork is not hot, so it's gonna cook so quick. You understand?
Well,
so
right now, or you cook, I'm hungry.
I know you're hungry. But these pot covers that we're using,
yes,
they are so French. It's
French.
It's French pot covers. The pot may look different, but it's also French pot covers.
Amen.
Because listen, these pot covers keep all the steam in the pot.
Okay.
And the steam is the thing that cooks
the
food.
Meat.
Some person may be cooking meat and they believe that it's
the pot cover
the whole for water that you put into the meat, but it's not like that. Is the steam actually cook the meat?
Okay.
And some people just throw a whole lot of water into the meat.
Yes.
And think it's gonna cook fast and that. But the less water you throw in the pot,
it's and
just
turn on,
it's better for the meat
to cook.
For the meat to cook.
So ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to Creative Cooking by Spotlight. This is our little Spotlight corner right now. And of course, our executive chef, Errol, he's also a singing chef. And he's going to give us a little song, a little karaoke song. I don't know if Lamar can sing. Can you sing, Lamar?
No, I
can't. No? Okay. No problem. It's all about Spotlight's corner.
Yes.
And Spotlight's creative cooking. Food and music goes well together. So Country is going to give us his rendition of Hank Williams' I Saw the Light.
Amen.
Yeah, man.
Wondered an aimless life lived with sin, and lived my dear Savior in. Then Jesus came like a stranger in the night. Praise the Lord, I saw the light. I saw the light. I saw. Oh, no more darkness, no more night. Now I'm so happy, no sorrow inside. Praise the Lord, I saw the light. Just like a blind man wandered along, worry and fear, claiming my own. Then like the blind man that God gave sight, praise the Lord, I saw the light, I saw the light, I saw, oh yeah, no more in darkness, no more in night, now I'm so happy, sorrow inside, praise the Lord, I saw the light. Wondered and strayed, I wrote the way, and strayed is the way. Now I have dread, the wrong for the right. Praise the Lord, I saw the light. I saw the light, I saw. Oh, one day no more in darkness. Now I'm so happy, no sorrow inside. Praise the Lord, I saw the light. Yeah, man.
Yeah,
man, right here, Kevin Hill Carter, isn't it?
Spotlight Carter. But ladies and gentlemen, come on, what do you have to say for the man? Country, the second chef,
great.
I'm telling you, praise the Lord, I saw the light.
That was great.
And I'm quite sure I'm going to see the light when the food finishes.
Yeah, indeed.
All right, so what, you know what, welcome, we'll be back. We will be right back
in a while.
These messages in a while, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you very much. Stay tuned for more entertainment and food. Back to Spotlight's Corner. Spotlight's Creative Cooking. Creative Cooking by Spotlight. Aral and Lamar is with us. And I'm telling you, the food smelled good. We gave you some entertainment a while ago.
Wow, Country, it was amazing.
Singing chef, I must tell you. Now, Country, when did you start singing?
Oh, when I started singing first... I think this is a natural blessing.
From God.
I think it's a natural blessing from God, because there and then, I find it very emotional at times, you know, mm-hmm. from a tender age. I remember the first song that I've ever performed in front of a big audience was the Siree, the man of Siree. You know, that was the first song I remember when I was going to a church.
And that was done by big artists like John Flemings and those people.
Mm-hmm. Yes. But I didn't know that time that I could have actually go in that
Main
in front.
Street.
I could have faced so much person. You know, it was like a rally kind of thing.
So put on the phone, nobody answer it. Okay. So what do you love more, singing or eating? Or cooking, singing or cooking.
Both of them.
Well, I love singing. I love singing. And passionate. I love to cook and just let people enjoy. You know, enjoy the food and enjoy a good vibe, having a good time. You know.
So about you, Lamar?
Well, as for me, I cannot sing a lot, but I grew up in church and I learned to sing at church. I sing on the youth choir, and all that. But in my experience of cooking, I grew up with my grandmother. Her name is Rita Olga Miller Murray. That's my grandmother. Rita Olga Miller Murray. Her married name is Murray. They call her Miss Dugsy. She was a very, very great cook. I can remember back in the days when I'm a youth, I used to see my grandmother cut this thing to cook. I was wondering what she's doing with cocoa leaf to cook. But in the past, I get to know that it's Injun kale.
Wow.
I never know that Injun kale can make a good seasoning.
Kale.
Yes, that's Injun kale. Make a good seasoning. Like the same way how you use the thyme and scallion. That was a good terms. I could not know. When I eat it, I lick my finger like this. Wow. And that's how I get to cook from my grandmother until now.
But you know what about the cocoa leaf? I didn't know that cocoa leaf could have eaten myself. I did not know that until... Few years, I think it was about a year ago, 2 years ago now. I realized that it could have actually eat. They strip it like the Kualalu. I think is Grenada National. They have Grenada National dish is Eilidh Down.
Yes.
For example,
because I don't have a clue of what Grenada is about.
Yes. Because he don't really cook, so he's getting the ideas of
what
you know,
to
right.
Cook,
so
to
this cooking. Season and episode that I'm doing is just to learn in the process.
What
now,
to do?
A lot of Jamaican people grew up with them granny, and the ones that grew up with them granny,
That's the great cook,
and they can tell about them cooking from scratch.
Yes, and the natural way too, the really natural way, the natural
cooking. Even in this country, I always talk about natural. I don't have a clue when I talk about natural.
No, when
yes,
I said
you
natural.
Do your natural cooking, like say you're gonna blend a carrot, you just wash it off, dice it, blend it, you don't cook it, nothing at all. That's natural cooking. Your natural beetroot, you beat it and just blend it out. That's natural cooking.
The fact is, you know, why a person said all of this, but like, but it, that you don't know, is that when you go natural, it is good for you.
It is
for
the
example,
best way.
You can use carrot
and sweeten it with sugar,
yeah,
raw milk,
with a little ginger.
Okay. That's the good natural way. Most people are
having
a little
bit. Lavada gave you a ginger.
We are talking. We are having a discussion.
Which one? You grew up with your granny. Who you grew up with?
Well, I grew up with my granny too. My grandmother was the one that grew me. Marita, Rita Marita Spence. No, we call her catapult tongue.
Go ahead.
And I'm telling
it's
you.
It's all about funny.
Sorry. My apologies.
My apologies. It's all about fun. Go ahead, bro.
All right. So the fact is that she taught me a lot of things. Cooking. She taught me a lot of things. A lot of cooking. I remember we're going all over the place, as you can see, because it's a spotlight corner. Creative cooking. So, you know, it's just article.
I need a drink. But go and talk.
All your mine and my pork what cooking around here. Yes.
But I hope you don't go around there and take none of the pork out of the pot. But anyway, that's all right.
But listen.
So the fact is, all of these things come together. When I said natural, because we differ from it a while. But when we said natural, what I'm talking about is the healthier way. You understand? And not only that, you can use carrot, Irish potato, pumpkin, ginger, and skeleton, thyme, onion, all of these things, and you blend them together and use a little vinegar. You understand? After you blend all of these ingredients together, natural ingredients, you understand? You put them together. It's like blending it, putting herbs and stuff together. I use that naturally because the vinegar, marinate everything, put everything, combine to everything.
Yes.
It's all natural. You can
as
use it
time goes by, I'm sure I'm going to learn all of that you've been talking about.
And I hope
about.
You try all
because
of it.
Because in one of
the
episodes that's coming up, I will be doing it myself instead of having an assistant. And they will be judging me and tasting the food and tell me oh, it's, if I did a good job or not. So this is just a learning process and all that. You can make dukuma?
Dukuno?
No.
Dukuno?
Yes. Dukuno.
Sorry, dukuno.
Blue jaws.
Blue
jaws,
yes. As my friend would said,
that's a
blue pani. But we call it
Bukunu,
or we call it blue jaws.
Authentic Jamaican. Is it a meal or fruit? What is it?
No, it's a meal. It's
authentic
a meal.
Jamaican meal called Dukuno.
Dukuno.
Mm-hmm. And some people call it blue jaws. Wrapped up in what? Banana leaf?
Yes, banana leaf. Banana leaf. It's a texture of.
You know what I want?
Yes.
I'm going to give you two little homework. We want to try some. Show me how to make some real Jamaican traditional food.
No problem.
I'm talking back from even before Aki and Saltfish.
Yes.
Yes. But ladies and gentlemen, Spotlight's Corner and
yes.
Creative Cooking by Spotlight. And I'm learning so much with these
indeed.
Two right now about how much they grow up with their granny and how much they can cook, how they love their food when they don't eat.
It's amazing.
Oh my God. So, the pork is on the pot. You know,
yes.
The pork.
Yeah, we're
it's already
it's
complete.
We're going to touch up a little bit of the cooking again after this because I want
now
you to
see.
Now
we're heading off now
we
to
have,
blend in carrot
we're
juice.
Looking about, we look about the pork and the rice and peas.
Yeah.
We're going to look about the all-natural
carrot
all
juice.
Natural,
and then we're gonna
carrot
fry,
juice, Jamaican.
Jamaican carrot
chicken.
Juice.
Carrot juice.
And the
that's what
the
we
chicken.
Used to eat every, we used to have every Sunday with the rice and peas.
Yes.
And the ackee and saltfish is supposed to be our Jamaican
national
dish. But I think it's rice and peas and chicken. Should be your national dish. But every Sunday we used to have that.
Yes.
And the carrot juice, natural. When I buy everything natural today, we're going to sweeten it and we're going to have a wonderful thing. And not to mention, this man's favorite drink is going to be in the carrot juice. His Guinness. The man Spotlight. He love Guinness.
All right. I need a drink of Guinness right now. I need
yes.
a drink of Red Label.
Now we're getting ready to go fricassee chicken. I've never done this before. I wanted to do barbecue fry actually today, but unfortunately because of circumstances, so we're not gonna be doing that. We're gonna do one of our own. You know, sometimes in the end of the kitchen, and you put pepper and hot oil.
That guy to kill me.
Maybe a little thingy, a little set.
The pepper.
What we're gonna be doing right about now? I think we should put because I like, we have to be putting. We have to put in a little barbecue sauce and the chicken for it to have a little color.
A soy sauce, that thing.
Soy sauce.
Apparently, country burn the pepper.
Then we apply the chicken just like that. Already seasoned, chicken was already seasoned, I guess. They already seasoned and everything. And we're just putting in everything. One more. Right into the pot.
I want big food, you see that?
Yeah, I tell you. Mm-mm, I tell you it's a big food. And they have this thing.
Suddenly.
So we have this chicken, we start brown the chicken. Wow! But never mind, we have it. Black man, so black man has to go home to take more. What? Yeah, man, it's a black man, you know, black man, I'm learning. So, because we know all the kitchen, why don't you tell us about that? But the time is just a little hot and all of that, but we just get it. So, after that, we'll come back with the finishing done. Spotlight Corner.
Back Creative Cooking by Spotlight, and the meal is done. It's finished, and I'm going to taste it and see how well does it taste. But before we do so, I would like to thank Errol, a.k.a. Country, and Lamar for making this a delicious meal. Thank you very much again, and thank you for making creative cooking.
You took my heart, all my keys, and my patience. You took my heart, I must leave a decoration. You mistaken my love, I brought for you for foundation. All that I wanted from you was to give me something that I never had, something that you never seen, something that you never been. But I wake up and nothing's wrong. Just get ready for work, 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 work. You tell me I be work, 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 work. You see me do me dirt, 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 dirt. Tell me about that work, 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 work. Da 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 da. When you walk out, da 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 da. Before the table turn, 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 turn. Beg you something, please, baby, don't you leave. Don't leave me stuck here in the street. Against you, I just hope that it gets to you. I hope that you see this through. I hope that you see this true. What can I say? Please recognize I'm trying, baby. I feel why, 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 why. It's me, I feel why, 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 why. You see me do my da 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 da. Tell me about that why, 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 why. When you walk out, la 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 la. When the care from my ta 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 ta.
Yeah. Get done, 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 done at work, come over. We just need to slow the motion. Don't get out of the way to no one. Long distance, I need you. When I see potential, I just gotta see it through. If you had a twin, I would still choose you. I don't wanna rush into it if it's too soon. But I know you need to get done, 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 done if you come over. Sorry if I'm way less friendly.